Good morning, everybody. Today is Saturday. It's Memorial Day weekend here in the States. And decided while I have a little bit of quiet time this morning, and I don't think anybody's going to be up to create any commotion, I'm thinking that I may want to finish the heart, the bottom heart, for this mother's knot that we started in the last video. Since that video, I couldn't help myself. I had to go in and do all of the detail work. I just wanted to see what it would look like and make sure I was going right in the right direction. And I really love it, and I'm getting some really positive feedback on social media. So I think I'm gonna keep going with it. Today we're gonna just do this bottom part and finish that, and then in some future video I'll tackle doing the framework and some miscellaneous detail work like these flowers and maybe a little bit of line work. But for today we're just gonna do the bottom heart and this center loop. I realized the last video I forgot to show you where this came from, because there was an original drawing from this a couple years ago. Like I said, I decided to do a mother's knot design, and I was exploring mother's knots, and I came across this one pattern, and I had to kind of work it out on grid paper to figure out how I would need to draw it. And yeah, so I mapped it all out on grid paper, roughly. And I think at some point I might create a tutorial. So I have the steps that I took down here. So I may do a tutorial on that. But that's later on. This was the drawing that came from that. So this was the original drawing that I made. I did this in colored pencil. I really, really loved it. So I decided I wanted to wood burn it, because I thought it would look really, really nice on a piece of wood. It's wood burned. So that's where the drawing came from. Now, this time around, I'm doing this as a wood burning project, but I'm thinking in the future I may do another version of this where I wood burn. I do a combination of wood burn and colored pencil. I think that would be spectacular, but I wasn't ready to do that right now. So we're just going to get started. I have a lot to do today, so we're just going to kind of get started. Pick a spot, any spot, right? Pretty sure my burner's ready. Yes, it is. All right. So we're just going to get started here, and again, like I usually do, all I'm doing in this video is just laying down just some basic shading. That's really all I'm doing in this one. I will go back off camera and, you know, do the fine details and things that I have to pay really close attention to, you know, clean up, that kind of stuff. All those fine little details that go into it. So let me know in the comments what you think of this, what you think of this, the dark with the light. I'm kind of really liking it. And my thoughts are that the frame is going to be similar tones as this mother's knot here. I think it'll help everything stand out really well. So that's kind of my vision. That's what I'm going for. So yeah, we're just gonna go in. We're gonna spend, I don't know, maybe 20 minutes. Hopefully it won't take me more than that. So what is everybody doing this fine holiday weekend? I realize probably some of you, by the time you see this, it will be well past that, but I for me, it's a working weekend. I'm just trying to get caught up on some things because I lost a couple of days. I had my son is a senior this year in high school, and he had a VOTEC graduation. He went to a technical school for commercial art, and he had his graduation, which kind of snuck up on us, and they didn't give us a lot of notice for the date. So I was dealing with that for a couple of days, and then we have his high school graduation in a couple of weeks. And he is my youngest child, my youngest. So this is really surreal this year, really surreal. It hasn't quite registered yet that this is the last one. This is the last graduation, except for maybe college or something like that. My oldest son is in, he's taking college courses for welding, and I don't know if they have like graduations for that or not. I don't know. But my youngest son, who's graduating now, is planning on going to Delaware County Community College, so. I'm sure there'll be more stuff happening within the next year or two, but as far as high school goes, this is it. All my sons are grown men. I have three sons. One's a mechanic and doing pretty good for himself right now. So I'm really proud of them, proud of all of them. They've grown up to be three fine young men. Can't ask for more than that, right? So now that they're grown, it's now my turn to put a lot of my own dreams on hold for a while, and I tried to follow certain aspects of my dream, and it's very hard when you're living paycheck to paycheck and you got kids to raise and stuff. It's very hard to do this kind of stuff, which is why I'm so backed up. I have so many projects. A lot of things I started, a lot of things I want to start. Let's see. I feel like I'm kind of jumping around, but it's all right. It all gets done, right? So if you're not following me on social media, you can go ahead and go into my channel description, my about information. I have all of my social media there, and you'll see me sharing things there. Short videos, you know, like real stories and photos of some of the stuff that I'm working on as I'm working on it. So I'm on Facebook. And Instagram. I'm on Pinterest. I'm on Twitter, but I'm no longer really using Twitter. I have no traction on Twitter at all, so I just gave up on it. I'm on LinkedIn. I'm in the process of trying to build up my LinkedIn profile. But I am on LinkedIn. And, what else did I say? Yeah, Facebook and Instagram mainly. Pinterest would be the third. And then, and that's my cat. You'll hear howling in the background. I don't know what it is. He's like got the zoomies. He's got a bunch of energy and he's running around. They Both, I think both of my cats are running around. Anyway, perfect time for them to have the zoomies, right? While I'm trying to do a video. Anyway, what was I saying? Okay, so yeah, I'm on mainly on Facebook. I would say Facebook first, Instagram second, Pinterest third, and then I'm trying to build up my LinkedIn. So, my website itself, I have a blog. So if you're interested in anything that's home decor, DIY, plant care, a little bit of gardening, faux florals, fairy stuff, fairy gardens, Celtic art, anything like that, you will find a lot of blogs there on my blog page that you can go ahead and read, and you know, if you like it, feel free to comment. I do respond to comments on my blog, so if you want to comment, we can definitely have a discussion. And feel free to share my blog too if you like it. Go ahead and share it. I would say share it on Pinterest. You can try. I'm not a coder. I'm having an issue trying to get the coding to work from Pinterest on my website. That's something I got to work out. At some point, I'll figure that out. So I don't know if you're going to be able to pin anything from my website to Pinterest if that's your thing. This is going pretty quick. Again, I'm just, because I don't know how much quiet time I'm going to have, I am kind of going kind of fast here. I am going to go back and work on the details off camera. I was hoping to have this finished by now, but, you know, like I said, things happened, and I was kind of out of commission for a couple of days. So, this should definitely be done by the end of this week, because there's very little left to do. And there's stuff left to do, but I can do it pretty quick, I think. Knock on wood, right? And I have a tree of life plate finished, ready for me to put a clear coat on it, and then this will be finished by end of the week, ready to put a clear coat on it. And then the two pieces will be listed on my website for sale. So that'll be nice to have them listed. I'm in the process of trying to build up my inventory, so I'm trying to finish a whole lot of projects that I started so that I can build up my inventory, and then I have some ideas for some new projects, so I gotta finish the old ones before I start the new ones. Otherwise, I'm just gonna have a whole lot of unfinished projects like I do now. It's no good. I guess it's an artist thing. I hear a lot of artists do that. They start a lot of stuff. My problem is just time. I plan to do things, get a bunch of stuff done, and then life kind of steps in. It's like, nope, no you don't. I am having some problems with my back, and that sometimes creates a problem for me. All right, we are almost done. We got this last loop done, and then I will wrap it up. This last little bit. mainly just kind of making these videos just to show you my process, show you what can be done, and my, I just wonder why things are getting lighter. This little thing, this knob turns, I gotta keep an eye on it. I am gonna get a nicer wood burning kit, hopefully sometime soon. I just need a little bit of cash flow to purchase it. So I'm getting a little tired of having to constantly look at my gauge. I like this little burner. I can switch out a bunch of, you know, I got a lot of different kinds of nibs, but honestly, I like this one. I use it for everything. I do have a shading nib, and I have like a bunch of other nibs that I can use to create different effects. I've tried them all. At the end of the day, I think I'm more into the line work drawing kind of thing than all that fancy stuff. So this works pretty well. Occasionally I might have to swap it out for something else, but the other issue, reason why I don't like to swap out nibs, is because, you know, you gotta let the thing cool down before you take off this, you know, the nib, because it's super hot. So you gotta wait for that, and then you gotta put the new nib on, and then you gotta wait for your burner to heat back up again. And I would rather just keep going with my work. I don't want to keep losing momentum. So that's the issue I've had in the past with that. I just lose momentum all the time because I have to stop and wait. So I've learned how to do a lot of things just with the main pointed burner. Now, I know there's a lot of wood burners out there, pyrographers out there. They go deep into the wood. They really press hard, and they make all kinds of different effects and stuff like that. But that's not really what I'm doing here with this Celtic art, anyway. It's more of a gentle hand, I think. Looks like we are just about done. Just about. Okay, so that's not perfect. Again, off camera, I'm going to go back in and I'm going to shade it to make it look, you know, nice like the top one does. But that is the bottom one for today. I have the camera rather close to my workpiece, so I can't show you like the entire board, but when I'm done, I'll probably do a video where I move the camera up a little bit so you can see everything. But anyway, so that's it for today. Just a quick one today. I think that was maybe 20 minutes or something like that. Yeah, just about 20 minutes, 19 minutes. So off camera, I'm going to go in and do the details, and then the next video, I think I'll be tackling the framework, and I'll be using a little bit of different technique with that. I think I might do dot work in here, and then these borders here may be a similar tone to this. This here might be, it's either going to be dark like these, or it's going to be a similar tone to this. I haven't made up my mind yet. So I'm really just kind of making this up as I go. I'm just trying to feel my way through it. I'm trying to let the artwork tell me what it wants. And I'd be a little more intuitive instead of forcing my will on it. So hopefully that's working out well, and this is a nice looking piece. So again, leave some comments, share the video if you like it, And well, until next time, have a great day.